Hey, what's up, y'all? Welcome back. In this video, we're going to be talking about how to create a chatbot in Messenger. Now, I've been building chatbots for a couple of years now. I've built hundreds of them. And so I'm going to outline a really simple way that you can create your very first chatbot, even if you're not that techie. Coming up. Hey, what's up, y'all? My name is Chris Abbott, but all my friends just call me Abbo. And in this video, we're going to be outlining a simple strategy for creating a chatbot inside of Messenger. Now, I primarily work with churches, so a lot of my examples are going to be with churches, but everything we're walking you through here in this video can apply to businesses as well. So let's dive in. All right, so first off, what exactly is a chatbot? It's kind of a confusing word, and honestly, it can be pretty intimidating if you've never seen one before. So in its simplest form, a chatbot is simply a series of automated sequences that live inside of Facebook Messenger and basically allow your people to do kind of like a choose your own adventure text message. So what you can do is you can actually set up different automated sequences will fire based on what the user clicks on or how they respond. Okay, so let's dive in and let's talk about how to create your first chatbot. Before you ever start building your chatbot, the first thing you need to do is define a win. You need to figure out what exactly is your end goal. Are you trying to sell something? Are you trying to get people to sign up for your newsletter or maybe sign up for a strategy call? Or if you're a church, are you trying to get someone to visit on Sunday morning or maybe sign up for a small group or a volunteer team, right? So start with the end in mind and you need to figure out what exactly is your end goal. What action do you want the user to take? So number two, what is the hook? Now, if you are a business, this might be that you're promising the solution to your prospect's problem. Or if you're a church, this might be as simple as asking people how you can pray for them this week. With a lot of our partner churches, we not only use prayer, but we also invite people within driving distance of your church to sign up for a Discover Your Purpose quiz or a free 21-day marriage challenge. So figure out what exactly your hook is going to be and then move on to number three. All right, number three, whiteboard the entire chatbot. Now, notice we're already on step three and we haven't even opened any software yet. This is really important. This is gonna make the build process go really, really fast, right? So you wanna figure out exactly what are the automated responses gonna be. Because just like those old choose your own adventure novels back in the day, you wanna figure out, hey, when we ask this question, if people say yes, take them over here and what do we wanna say? And if they say no, take them down here and see what they wanna say. So I've actually seen real estate agents use this to collect leads for people that are looking for houses, right? So they might say, what size house are you looking for? Right? 0 to 2,000 square feet, 2,000 to 4,000, 4,000 plus. And then based on which one they choose, it takes them to a different response. Now in the church world, you can do the same thing, especially if you're doing some type of quiz or a challenge chatbot. So it's really important to draw it out in front of a whiteboard, to draw out each one of your questions, and then to draw arrows to the next box based on how they respond to your chatbot. All right, number four, build it in ManyChat. There are a lot of different chatbot solutions out there. My favorite by far is ManyChat, right? They actually have a visual kind of drag and drop builder to make it really, really easy, right? So now all you have to do is recreate the exact thing that you drew out on your whiteboard and you just do it inside of ManyChat. So oftentimes, even if you are doing this for the very first time, you can build an entire chatbot in only 30 minutes. It's important to write everything out on a whiteboard before, but now that you've done that, all you have to do is build it straight into ManyChat and you can do it pretty quick. All right, so before I get to my last two points, would you share this video with someone? Chatbots are absolutely the future and we're gonna start to see them everywhere and people need to know about them. Would you send this to one or two friends that you think need to know about chatbots? All right, number five, now it's time to test it. So now that you whiteboarded out your entire chatbot and then you built it out inside of ManyChat, now it's time to test it. We never wanna release a chatbot into the wild and actually start sending people to it until we have tested it out and making sure that everything fires exactly the way that it's supposed to. Oftentimes, you'll be testing things out and you'll realize that you may have just connected one response to the wrong box, or you forgot to connect one of the responses to a box and it's not firing. So testing this is a great way just to work out all the bugs and making sure that everything is working exactly as it should. So I recommend testing it yourself and then having at least one other person who's unfamiliar with your business or your church test it out as well, because you wanna know how a regular person is gonna respond to this chatbot, not just you or someone in your organization who knows how it's supposed to go. All right, and finally, send people to your chatbot. Now, there's a couple of different ways that you can do this. My personal favorite way is to use targeted Facebook ads to send people to your chatbot. But you can also put this on your website, or you can send an email to your email list, or you can even post it on social media. Once you've created your chatbot, it's time to send as many people into that bot as possible. Now, I actually worked with a church in Idaho recently that used a chatbot to deliver a quiz, and in 3 days, they had 37 people go through the quiz, and 8 new families scheduled an appointment to visit that church the very first Sunday. All right, so if this sounds interesting to you, I wanna encourage you, go out there, ready, fire, aim, start before you're ready, and just go start creating chatbots and testing them out to see how they work. Now, if this sounds a little bit too complicated to you, or if you're intimidated, or you're saying, Chris, listen, I just don't have time to learn a new thing, then feel free to reach out to me and my team. We'd be happy to have a conversation about what it would look like to set this up for your church. Just go over to churchgrowthagency.com or simply click on the link in the description below. We'll see you soon.